We're heading out to the restaurant.
Pangalan ng restaurant ay Ox.
Ox.
Yes, Ox.
It's the Michelin restaurant.
It's a Michelin restaurant. So, it's next level.
Wow.
Social climbing. You have no idea. Pagkain.
Ano kaya? Huh? Ano kaya?
Marami ring tao dito mga taon-taon kasi holiday ngayon. It's Iceland Republic Day. Kaya maraming tao.
We'll see you there. Mamadali na kami kasi late na kami eh.
I'm not sure I can see it.
Dito na tayo sa location pero hindi pa.
Doon, maghintay lang tayo.
So, hintay lang tayo.
Hi!
Tara!
Good, man.
Grab a seat. Just
thanks.
In time.
Thanks. Marcus told me that it's going to start at 7:30.
Oh, all good. All good. No stress. Just checking in for you guys.
Yeah, thanks.
If you want to hang up your coat, you can put it on the side. All right. Or we can put it here. Just started. One bill for both of you guys, right? Both drinking, right?
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Hi.
My wife.
First drink. We're always starting here with champagne. So this is Jean Laurent. So 100% Pinot Noir. Good crisp, settled through long glass. Family run. Third generation, you're gonna have it for the first little couple of bites.
So you start on this one. So it's a crispy potato. We dust it with a little bit of dashi salt. The foam is made from Icelandic rapeseed oil, from Moya. Seasoned with miso, and then on top is fermented potato bagel. So just dip it in, the more sauce, the better.
Right.
about the restaurant itself. It's a speakeasy restaurant hitting behind Suma. And the idea is, you know, you guys coming into the home of the owner, Travis, so the interior is built by his grandfather. So easy going vibe. Trying to get people to mingle to food and wine. And my name is Runat, I'm the chef. And then we have Gulke and then Agnes. So we'll all be serving with food and wine. Lokana first part is this one, which is a classic Icelandic bite. It's leva bread, fried bread that we eat on Christmas. We put a little bit of lamb tartare in it, green juniper emulsion. You see some cheese and then Spanish chervil, been preserved for a city. And the top part is some smoked lamb. I recommend taking one bite. Enjoy.
But I don't know, it's
like,
we bake it and then we cool down, boil it for 6 hours around, and then we dehydrate. It's very chewy, very candy-like. Beneath it, a little bit of Icelandic cheese called tinta, which is smoked, do a cream out of it. Preserved rhubarb from last summer. The top part is a leather of red beets and cloves, seasoned with a little bit of fennel pulp.
Okay.
So how have you been?
Good. Yeah. I'm on actually vacation.
Oh, you're on vacation?
Yeah, for a month.
Oh, damn. Wow, that's a good one. So you're going to go back home? Or
No. We're just going around Iceland.
Okay, nice.
So we're back. We were in a summer house for 3 days. And we're going back here for this, and we're gonna go around Iceland again.
Oh, amazing! You're gonna have a schedule, huh?
Yeah. Then
you moved here, man? You moved here. You were in the Philippines, right?
No, she's in the Philippines.
Oh, you're in the Philippines.
Yeah, okay. She's still living in the Philippines, but. Hopefully.
Hopefully the trip around the country will be
right.
Yeah.
but halang nagpalit tayo ng pesto.
Yeah, I think it's duck.
Bacon. Next on the menu, we have an Icelandic whale for you. A bird, not a big animal. We are getting it from Stuck's unit, from one farmer that threw an accident to one on Facebook.
Check it.
Yes. Beautiful smile. So yeah, we are lightly frying this whale on a pan and then glaze it in in-house meat unagi. On top of that, we have a little bit of pickled plums. And next to it, you see a dot, which is mole. And for those who don't know, mole is a Spanish word for a sauce. So this is our take on it. The base is plums. And after that, I was just walking around the kitchen and collected a lot of good ingredients. So that you're going to remember. And the darker dot, it's a unagi for you to taste it by itself. I hope you enjoy this.
Icelandic whale.
I'm going to start with my
scallops. The next one. Tawag dito ay nilasing na hipon.
We're going to serve it raw this time to showcase the delicious sweetness of it in the summertime. Lightly seasoned with some salt and olive oil. And then below it is a yuzu gel, some arrangement of marigold leaves, lemon thyme, and oregano on top of the shrimp. And then Agni is finishing the dish with a tomato consomme and seasoned with marinated tomatoes or tomato essence. So, hope you enjoy.
Masyado na nila yung
guys want to go downtown after this? Celebrate as well?
Maybe.
I think so.
It depends.
It depends?
Yeah. Most likely.
Most likely. Yeah. I think you'll be in the mood.
True.
I've seen a couple different guests.
Yeah.
Have to have it on the menu. So, Sebastian report, sunset. We are now in France, Loire Valley, and Sebastian is a winemaker who does everything by hand, no machinery included. That's why it's only 120-140 bottles produced a year. And since Crown likes it so much, he just buys all of it, this kind. So we could have enough for a year for Oaks guests. It's natural wine, 100% Sauvignon Blanc, but if I haven't told you it's natural, you would have never guessed it, because it's very well balanced, has a little bit of apricoty taste, and the next course is quite fatty, so it should cut right through it. And this is a very special wine, we all fight for it in our summer tours. So we created a dish to suit the wine, not the other way around that we usually do. So I hope you are going to enjoy this.
Say it's kind of a green energy as it comes first, and then why am I defending by reusing the midterms for the restaurant and the hotel? So it's really moist because I'm just like a